All right, then. Who cares about that? Let's get this shit on the road and let's get it delivered.
All right. Looks like a storm up ahead.
Storms are brewing.
But we're loaded.
The warden led a prisoner down the hallway to his doom. I stood up, say goodbye like always.
Good selection of music.
And I heard him tell the warden.
We can even sing along if you know the words.
Well, I think probably it's a good thing I don't know the words to the song.
Sing me back home. Sing me back home.
Sing it, Eddie.
Getting dark. Better put the lights on.
Oh, thank you, Chris.
I bet she can harmonize real good, Annie can. Can you harmonize real good?
I don't know.
You're just modest.
I recall last Sunday morning.
Black Sources, haha, 2 weeks ago I was in Florida in Naples. I really enjoyed Cracker Barrel's country music.
This old guy, one time when I was still listening to, I knew this was the boss battle here. This old guy, he picked me up hitchhiking when I was a college student. Had country music on.
Oh.
And he goes, "So, youngin, did you like country music?" And I go, "Well, no, sir, no, I really don't. I'm just kind of stupid myself." He goes, "Well," says, "so you will continue to think that, and then you're going to discover the perfect country song. When you hear the perfect country song, you will know that that song was written for you."
Wow.
"And that will change your..." God damn it, don't crash into his fucking thing.
No, don't, and don't.
"That will change your attitude towards country music."
And what was it for you, Eddie?
Good question.
Ah!
Wait a minute, this is... Wait.
Phew, that was
close.
Oh,
I think we fucked up. So which way are we going, anyway? I guess I better look at the map.
Story of Bonnie and Clyde is a story the old folks knew.
Ooh, Bonnie and Clyde. Oh, is that a one way? Are we going the wrong way on?
We must be going the wrong way.
Oh my god. You too, that's it. Are we stuck in the mud?
Maybe.
They were so
well known through a dozen states or more. Then Clyde's brother Buck and his pretty wife Blanche joined them when that made up the famous Barrel Gang.
So this here is supposed to go this way. There's an arrow.
Bonnie Parker was a poet and Blanche Barrel was a cook.
Yeah, I thought we just came from here, though.
Was a fast
Look on the map. Oops. I'm gonna pull over. Take a look at the map.
And soon they were all famous in their own peculiar way. The stories were so many that you couldn't read them all.
It was just a sign.
Okay, so now I'm going this way. And my destination is... Where's my destination? Amsterdam, it looks like. My destination is Amsterdam.
Wow.
Diggers to Amsterdam. Okay, so I'm going the right way then. Okay, all right, so.
Ooh, are we going to go and see those pretty ladies in the windows?
I might walk on past just to kind of take a look. I've never seen any before.
Ooh. Just kind of window shop.
I'll tell you what, I'm more interested in them there coffee shops. I need me some coffee.
Oh, yeah.
You, fucker, you just ran right into me.
Yes, we did, Joster.
And the worst thing is, I think I really might have to go to Amsterdam.
Really?
My supplies of you-know-what.
Yes.
Or let's say they're still solid and I'm not worried, but I can see in a couple weeks being destitute, in which case I would have to take action.
Oh, very much so.
Number one, when you left me, I never knew that I heartache number two was when you came back again. You came back and never meant to stay. No, I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more.
Aww.
Yes, I've got heartaches. The number, the love that I can't win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end.
Oh, hang in there, baby. It'll be all right.
We's almost there. It says 2 hours and 27 minutes.
Nice.
My GPS. Woo. Got me a GPS for the truck.
Then we could have some coffee and maybe get a bag of those bad boys.
Well, you betcha, baby. I'm planning that once we get done with this here road, with this here heavy load, we're going to drop off the heavy load and then we're going to party a little bit.
Woohoo!
Go to the hotel and maybe have ourselves a dinner.
Nice.
So, yeah, I thought that would please you.
Mm-hmm.
And we can go smoke some of that there funny tobacco.
And have some fizzy water.
Fizzy water with funny tobacco. That sounds good to me.
Every day you
love me less, each day I love you. Amsterdam's this way. We're almost there.
Nice.
God damn it. Stupid. Just trying to get too fancy. Showing off for the girl. No, no. No, that's where you go. Now watch this, baby. Yeah. Now watch this.
Oh, the guardrail.
Oh, the fuck. Just watch this. Yeah, watch this. Now watch this drive. Watch this drive. Stupid game. Come on now.
Let him go. You caught on something there, Eddie.
I know. I'm going to have to get out of the truck and take a look and see what it is. Oh, it's a goddamn sign. Fuck you, sign.
Eddie just loves those signs. Bus is like, you need any help?
Yes. Fine. Spent some time
in San Francisco. That expert driving man.
I spent a night there in the can. Lived through this treatment in my jail. And all stressed me out. I'm going to need a bad boy when we get to Amsterdam.
Oh, yeah.
Doesn't stress me out. Recovering my truck. my truck.
Oh yeah, having all that power under your seat.
Under my legs, you mean?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's a great power, must be used responsibly.
All those pistons pounding.
680 horsepower, mighty horsepower.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty impressive, ain't it?
Oh, it is. I love how it vibrates.
Well, no, that's not me. That's that plastic thing I got back in the sleeper.
So I take it you have plenty of batteries.
Yeah, I've got plenty of batteries, yeah.
Mm, you know,
they sell them at all the truck stops. Even if they're dead, we can always go buy some more.
Woohoo.
Might stop off and get me some of that there Cialis, too, while I'm at it. I'm telling you what, Nina's mom, I watch any sports.
Uh-huh.
They have those ads for Cialis and Viagra. I cannot bear to watch them.
Aww.
They drive me. I feel like my IQ is leaking out my ears when I watch those fucking things.
I know, aren't they ridiculous?
I can't. It. You know, and now they're doing them for like other drugs. And they're always like, you know, 15 seconds of. I saw this one drug they're doing it for, and it's like 15 seconds of, you know, better symptoms for your sickness, you know, better symptoms and less
right.
Whatever. And then 1 minute and 15 seconds of continual taking of this drug could cause blood clots, cancer, and eventual death.
Yes,
you
right.
know? And they're like going like, you know, do not take this thing if you, you know, have two legs. Do not take it if you, if you expect to live a healthy life. Like, I don't know. Like, they just kept saying all this shit about how dangerous it was.
Oh, I think I would run right out to my pharmacist and say, hey, I need some of this.
No, this was to like, cure some sort of disease. The other one was.
Well, here in America, fuck yeah. We always have those darn commercials all day long.
And don't you feel your IQ bleeding out your ears when you watch them?
Yeah, it's so stupid.
I can't bear the settings that they put those couples in. It's like sending, you know, shots of hot lead into my eyes. I'm serious. And there they are, they're like redecorating their fucking antique table or whatever. And they're painting their brushes, and then they happen to catch their eyes, and they smile, and then they decide to have like a little kissy poo. And then you switch to another couple out on the boat, and they're rowing, and one of them's tired, and the other one's making fun of them, but they both laugh, and then decide to have a kiss. Girl, I want to strangle!
It's like, okay, baby, it's time for me to take my Cialis, and it's time to fuck. That's what you want to see.
I'm telling you what, seriously.
Come on, baby.
Look, there's Amsterdam. Just like I pictured it. Whoa. Busy looking at Amsterdam, I sort of lost control of my vehicle.
I know, I think your palms are getting a little sweaty at the thought.
I'm hope they sell Cialis where we're going. The fuck?
Didn't miss the exit, did we?
What do you mean, baby?
Here we are.
We're there. Cutter, Joe Bob. I think the happy pills might have kicked in a little bit too much. Cutter, Joe Bob, we's almost there. Drop this here heavy load off so we can go make some whoopee.
Oh, yeah. Oh. It's one thing about heavy loads, boy. You gotta get rid of them.
Eventually.
You don't want to burst. You know that darn thing about blue balls and all that.
I will usually try to do some sort of manipulation to avoid that condition.
Ah.
Take matters into my own hands.
There you go.
For the safety of myself and my co-patriots, we don't want no explosions. That sticky substance.
Oh, no.
Hanner. Late. It's all your fault, Nina's mom.
Uh-oh.
It's all your fault. If you got here faster, I wouldn't have been late. That's okay, though, honey. I'm still going to pay you a Cosmopolitan magazine. See, we really have to stop laughing. I swear to you, it would be a lot funnier if we never laughed, but I know I can't do it. Get you a Cosmopolitan magazine so you can read in the sleeper. Okay. And we'll get ourselves a bottle of Jack. How's that sound?
Sounds good to me.
Yep. Maybe some crackers.
Oh, yeah, because you know it's always best to have those crumbs in the bed.
Well, it's that kind of thing where we go, well, I wouldn't kick her out of bed for eating crackers. So I figure we'd buy some crackers, that way I won't kick you out of bed.
Mm. And of course, that coffee needs a little cream to cool it down.
All right then, honey. Your wish is my command. I'm going to go into the 7-Eleven and get it. I'll be right back.
Okay, baby. Baby.
Hey, did you see this here? We did a Blues Brothers truck run here. We made this much money, but we lost this much money. And so our total is like $0. We didn't make no money on that run.
That stinks.
Well, I guess you're paying then, Nina's mom.
Isn't that always the way?
I'm sorry, honey. My credit card's in my other pants.
You mean the only pair of pants you brought along, right?
Well, yeah, but listen, just go get them anyway. Now, crackers and a bottle of JB and a Penthouse magazine for you, and get me a Guns and Ammo magazine for me.
Oh, to get them possums.
That's right. I'm going to shoot me some possums. Hey, I'm going to get me some coffee, too. I'll be right back.
Okay. Hey, the mixed boy. How are ya? Welcome. I hope you enjoy your stay. Eddie will be right back. He's gone for some coffee. Everyone in the room like a little bit of coffee once in a while, and how do you take that? Do you take it with sugar, without cream, or just straight up black? I like mine with cream. Are we all awake in here?
Well, I'm going down the Feather River Canyon. I gotta go Donna Summer just close. Another 80 miles and I'm so lonesome. I guess I'm gonna be late getting home. Road truck roll, take me to my baby. I'm tired of being alone. Road truck roll, I wanna see my baby. Road truck roll.
Oh, I'm sorry, Joster. I know, they say even the decaf, I guess, have a little bit amount of caffeine in it.
Yeah, one of these days I'm going to quit this old road. When I save me enough money.
Well, I like 7-Up, Sprite, the seltzers.
Yeah, my wife said that my little boy is not doing too good in school. I said he keeps talking about his dad that he hardly knows. And his teacher said he just sits at his desk and draws pictures of trucks. I guess I know what that means and what it shows. Well, you know, I'm not home about 3 months out of the year, and here lately...
I see, mixed boy. I like tea,
yeah,
too.
I saw a lot of country at first.
I take it straight up.
I liked it then, but anymore, there's just none of it new. And this has been one heck of a drive here, I tell you what. I have rain most.
I don't drink none of that tea shit.
It looks like it's gonna get
I drink manly drinks. Coffee.
I gotta keep
black.
My spirits up. I
puts hair on your chest.
This is a pretty
I
good
guess.
One
you drink that tea, Allen you're gonna end up with your little pinky finger right. extended every time you drink
I
it.
Like the way that old boy
you know where that's heading.
Well, I'm going down to Feather River Woo-hoo. Canyon. I gotta go down, Donner Summer just closed. Another 80 miles, and I'm so lonesome. I guess I'm
drinking
that
my
coffee.
Drinking my coffee, yeah, that's it. I'm thumbing through my copy of Guns and Ammo.
Mm-hmm.
We got some fine looking weaponry in there.
You gotta crunch on some of them crackers.
Yeah, here, have some crackers there, and here's a glass of JB for you.
Ooh, nice. Ooh, it's smooth.
Let's go ahead and get comfy.
Uh-huh.
With some good tunes on the radio. You remember this one here, Nina's Mom?
I sure do.
Well, people, I just got one thing to say. When this trailer's a-rockin', don't come a-knockin'.
Oh, yeah.
Hey there, Tree Fitty.
When you hear those moans and those screams.
Hey there, Tree Fitty Game, and I wanted to show them how much money I made here on my last run.
Okay.
Check it out, Tree Fitty. How much I made.
Zippo. But we had fun.
I think we better go to one of them there coffee houses. I heard they got them here.
All
yes,
right.
Some of them there funny weeds. The funny weeds. The funny stuff they grow here.
Tree Fiffy Gaming is here. Hello.
I know. He's a star. That guy's a star.
Just like you, Eddie.
Well, I'm a greater star, but I mean, I have to give people their props.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't matter if I'm, you know, the greatest broadcaster that ever lived in the history of the universe. Still, though, you got to recognize the little people.
The mixed boy says one of us have a California American accent.
I don't think it's me.
No, I don't think it's you, and I don't know how it could be me because I'm from New York.
If you're gonna do a California accent, you gotta talk through your nose. Say
it's a like.
So like. That was really awesome, dude. And like, if you take your surfboard out there and you go out there about 30 meters, you're gonna catch some awesome waves, dude.
Yeah, like so nice.
Awesome.
Totally.
Totally awesome, dude.
Let's do it.
Well, I guess that's the cue to put my copy of Guns and Ammo away.
Okay.
Put my Jack Daniels away and turn the lights off.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go ahead and do it then, honey. Turn the lights off.
All right, they're off.
I'm so tired from driving all that time. I'll tell you what, I think I'm going to have to just go ahead and go to sleep, honey. I hate to disappoint you tonight.
Aww.
Unless you might be able to revive me.
Ooh. You never know.
You can give it a try.
You never know what's going to crawl around in the dark.
This here's a good song. I think it might be making my Johnson hard already just listening to it.
Ooh.
Yepper, I'm ready now, honey. Let's go ahead and do it. When this trailer's rocking, don't come a knocking.
Ooh, baby.
Well, that was the
as
best.
As good for you as it was for me.
That was the best 13 seconds I ever had. All right then, baby, you know me, I'm a truck driver. We never stand on our laurels. We got to always get another load, another heavy load here. Let's go ahead and pick one up.
All right.
Amsterdam. What do we got here? Amsterdam to Dresden. Pays 32. No, I don't like 32. I want more money. This guy here is good. 57.86. This guy here pays good.
Is this sex or what?
I'm looking
the mixed
at
voices.
I'm looking at it's virtual sex like they got on that Second Life game. You ever heard of that game, Second Life? It's kind of like virtual sex.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this one here is going to Torino. It pays even more. Hold on, let me see this guy. How about a little trip to Italy?
Oh, sounds
that
good.
Sound good to you, honey?
Yes, that sounds great.
Okay, when's it expire? 10 hours and 58 minutes. All right, I'm setting it as my GPS destination. And let's see, am I sleepy? No, but I need to get my truck fixed. See, it's there. Okay. Gotta get my truck fixed. Whoops. Well, it didn't need to be there anyway, did it? Shit, where do you go in?
For some reason, it's black screen for me.
Oh, yeah, that's right, because I turned it off.
Oh.
Because I turned it off. I turned it off when we turned the lights out.
Oh, okay.
Well,
the mix boy, he's gonna go because I guess he's not been to our kind of chat.
I don't think anybody's ever been to this kind of chat, to tell you the truth.
Hey, you know, it's a long, lonesome road.
See, is this here where you prepare your truck?
I've got the will, Lord, if you got the tow.
Right. Truck maintenance and repairs. Great driver always keeps their vehicle in tip-top condition. $18,000. Okay.
Straight through the heart of them righteous uprights.
Drop kick me, Jesus, to the goalpost. All right, now we got to go pick up our.